Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today we'll make instant prawn biryani. This is the basic biryani which you can make regularly at home. No more spice, no more oil, no more ghee, and this is healthy also, so that we can make it frequently. So let's see the recipe of prawn biryani. Here I have taken 2 lb of cooked prawn. You can take fresh prawn, that will give you more taste, but right now I have cooked prawn only, so I have taken 2 lb of cooked prawn. Here I added handful of fresh mint leaves, and now again I am going to add handful of fresh coriander leaves. Just chop it and add it, and then we'll add the other ingredients. If you are taking fresh prawn, so before marinating, just fry the prawn with little salt and turmeric. In high heat, just fry it for 5 minutes and then marinate it. Here I am adding 1 tablespoon of lemon juice, and then we'll add the other spices. Here I am going to add 1.5 teaspoon of salt. But if you have taken fresh prawn and you have already fried it with salt and turmeric, just add 1/2 teaspoon of salt. And then I am adding 2 teaspoon of biryani masala or my homemade garam masala that I always use for my biryani. You can use biryani masala or garam masala. And I added 2 teaspoon of Kashmiri red chili powder. You can add normal red chili powder. 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. Now I am adding 1 teaspoon of coriander powder and 1/2 teaspoon of cumin powder, and then I'll add 1/2 cup of curd, and after that we'll mix all of these ingredients nicely, and I'll leave it for 30 minutes and then I'll start cooking. Here I'm going to take 2.5 cup of rice. Just use the normal cup size, the normal measuring cup. In that cup, here I have taken 2.5 cup of rice. Just wash it and soak it for 30 minutes, and then I'm going to cook the rice 75%, and then I'll add it to the biryani. Next, I'm going to take 1 medium size onion chopped and 1 medium size tomato chopped, and now after 30 minutes I'm going to take a heavy button pan, add 2 tablespoon of oil to the pan, heat the oil, and then add some whole garam masala like 2 bay leaves, 1 stick of cinnamon, 2 green cardamom, few cloves and few black pepper, and then I'm going to add the chopped onion. Fry the onion till it's golden brown, and then we'll add the tomatoes. Fry the tomatoes till it's cooked nicely, and then we'll add the marinated prawn. Now I'm going to add the marinated prawn, and we'll just cook 4 to 5 minutes the prawn. Here I have taken cooked prawn, and also if you have taken fresh prawn, you need to fry it first, so we don't need to cook prawn for a long time. Here just cook it 4 to 5 minutes, and then we'll put our rice. Now I'm going to add the rice. I have already cooked the rice. If you are using a rice cooker, then add 1.5 cup of water to 1 cup of rice, and then your rice will be 75% done, and add that rice on top of the prawn gravy. After adding rice, we'll add some milk and dry mint leaves, some black cumin and fried onion. Here I have added rice. Now I'm going to add some black cumin, and then some dry mint leaves I'll just press it by hand and I'll add it. If you don't have dry mint leaves, you can add fresh mint leaves also. And then I'll add fried onion. After adding onion, I'm going to add 1/2 cup of milk to this. I'm not going to add any ghee or color over here. If you want, you can add ghee or butter and some food color here. And after adding all this, just cover the pan. Bring the heat in between medium to low. Here I am keeping it on 3.5. After cooking for 20 to 25 minutes, you should check if there is any gravy at the bottom or not. If there is no gravy at the bottom, then it is done. See, it's totally dry at the bottom. So I'm going to serve it now. I'm going to serve it with simple raita. This usually tastes good with raita only. So you can try something else like salan or any chicken gravy or egg curry. So try this recipe and let me know how it came out. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel to get new recipe every Thursday and press the bell button to get notification when new recipes are uploaded.